The Cape Cod Rail Trail starts in Dennis. The trailhead is on Route 134. The distance I am traveling was to the Harwich Community Center, which was about 5 miles. The rail trail is pretty active during this time of the year, which is in May 2010. Although you don't see too many people on it at this time, the time is about 11 o'clock in the morning, but it was during a weekday. Occasionally you will see some rather heavy people on the rail trail. And that's good, because that shows you that these people, even though they're not in shape, are trying to get in shape, and that's great. The unfortunate thing is many of the people who are heavy are over at the nearby Stop and Shop, getting heavier. In any event, the rail trail is in pretty good condition. And as you can see, quite a bit of vegetation on each side of the rail trail. It goes through the towns of Dennis, Harwich, and then it divides. Part of it goes to Chatham, and then part of it goes off towards Provincetown. Here we're coming up to a major crossroad, and that is what is known as the dump road. You're supposed to stop and look to see if traffic's coming. However, when I lived in Austria for a month, bikes got the right of way. And you can see there's quite a bit of traffic on this road. And in order to avoid a bump there, I just kind of bounced along on the grass. But my feeling in Austria is bikes had the right of way. By law, they had the right of way. Strangely enough, in the United States, cars have the right of way. So there you are, pedaling along, and you have to stop for a car. A car who the person just have to barely move their foot in order to accelerate or decelerate. And you have to, and it also, the car also consumes quite a bit of gas, which fouls the air. But there you are on a bike. You have to give the car the right of way. However, as you will see many times as I come upon a street, there are signs that say stop, get off your bike. That would be a new record for me to stop and get off my bike. Now here we come up to a street, and you're not going to see me get off the bike at all. Boom, right across. I take my chances. My feeling very strongly that there should be signs that tell the cars to stop and give the bike riders the right of way. I will point out, however, that many cars do actually do that. When you're coming upon a street and a car sees you coming, they will give you the right of way. Generally, the people who are thin are the ones that give you the right of way. The heavy ones just want to get to where they're going. Sometimes I ride my bike to school, and that's on a fairly busy road, and you can see that on another video that I have. Should wear a helmet. I realize that my daughter is very upset that I do not wear a helmet when I ride my bike, but I probably should wear a helmet, but it's just too confining. But she does have a point. Now, I really don't love to ride a bike. Especially in this case, I was riding a bike to go play volleyball, which is exercise in itself. And then after volleyball, I was going to play a game of softball, which is a little more exercise. So why do I ride a bike if I don't really love it? Well, because I don't want to die. At my age, over 60, my feeling is if you don't get some exercise, you're going to die a lot quicker. And I notice a lot of people, as they get older, they seem to get wider. So my philosophy is let's ride that bike, at least try and do 25 miles a week. Now that's not very much. I have a nephew who lives in Wyoming, and I think that kid does, well, he's not a kid, he's over 40, but I think he does over 100, maybe 200 miles a week. Now that guy is in shape. and I'm probably at the bottom few percent of all bicycle riders. But then I would say people my age, 95% of those people do not ride a bike at all. So I guess I'm at the bottom 5% of the top 95%, if you can follow that logic. And there is another road going by, and you noticed once again I did not stop. I do look. I mean, I'm not crazy. If I see vehicles coming, and I really don't want to get hit. I did have one fellow that didn't want to give me the right of way, and I made a little slight motion with a part of my arm, shall we say, and I think he probably returned the favor. This is biking along right here. I'm right along the side of the road. There's a cranberry bog to the left, and the road is to the right. And it's somewhat of a slight upgrade. My average speed, I'm not too good. My average speed is about 11 miles an hour. Now, we'll be coming up on a tunnel here fairly soon, and I almost never meet anybody going the other way in the tunnel. You can see this time it was a little bit different. So I got to slow down when we're coming up to the tunnel. And here we are, slowing down a little bit so we can come up to the tunnel. Don't want to hit the person going the other way. And that tunnel goes under a road. And coming up here is the crossroads. This crossroads is where we can either go left towards Provincetown or right towards Chatham. And I'm going to take the right towards Chatham because I'm going into Harwich Center. And there's kind of like a little bit of a rotary here. And off we go into the rotary and then continue on. The Cape Cod Rail Trail follows a railroad right-of-way for about 22 miles through the towns of Dennis, Harwich, Brewster, Orleans, Eastham, and Wellfleet. As you can see, it's a fairly nice paved surface, not very many hills, and the automobile crossings are pretty well marked. It has also a fairly wide unpaved shoulder in case you manage to crash. There are many opportunities to get off the trail and visit a beach. Food and water are also available on some areas of the trail, and there are public restrooms, or you can just kind of run off into the woods. The rail trail, if you go left towards Provincetown, goes by the Nickerson State Park, goes by the Salt Pond Visitor Center at the Cape Cod National Seashore, and it also goes very close to the National Seashore headquarters. One of the problems you run into are bikers that like to ride side by side, and you can't get past them, and they don't pay much attention to you. Now, these people look like they're moving right along, but in actuality, they're only moving at about 7 miles an hour. And here we're coming up to Route 124, a major thoroughfare. This is the area where I generally have to slow down, sometimes get off the bike, but as you can see, I didn't do that this time. Now, I'm going to be getting off the rail trail and going up Oak Street towards the Harwich Community Center, and I'm going to be taking a left as we come up here, and we'll then park my bike and go in and play some volleyball. So let's come up and kind of take that left. Boom, there we go. There was a car that wanted me to go ahead, so I stayed on this side, but then I let him pass and off we go. So that's the trip up the Cape Cod Rail Trail, and hope you got a sense as to what it was like to go on the rail trail. The community center is coming up here right off to the left. Thank you.